Hello, Japs and Japettes. Welcome to Star Wars Day. So, today what we're going to look at is some science of Star Wars, and I've been watching The Mandalorian lately, and there was one scene in particular which struck me as being a particularly good physics one. And that's the scene where he's tracking the Rebel Shock Trooper. And that's actually quite a little bit fun. You can actually do that using a thermal camera. And it's a nice bit of physics. We'll go through it now. So the thing about this is that it uses something called infrared radiation. And that's actually essentially a color of light. It's a little bit less energy or lower energy than visible light, which is why you can't really see it. You're tuned in to see visible light, hence the name visible light. But infrared light is something that other creatures can see, and using special equipment, we can too. Anything that has heat energy inside, so anything that has a temperature, will give off a little bit of thermal, will actually give off a bit of infrared radiation, which is what the Mandalorian uses to track the Shock Trooper. As she's walking along, she's leaving a small heated imprint on the ground, and that means that, you know, he can detect that using his thermal camera. Now, this is a quite interesting thing, because if you shine this thermal image at someone, well, another little Star Wars quote comes to mind. And rather than talk about some more, let's go to the back of my classroom, and let's just show you this in practice. Right, now this is called a thermal camera. So it is an infrared imager, and it just looks like a standard camera. This thing's actually a dual-purpose one. It's got an infrared an infrared detector, and also a standard visible light detector. And what that means is it produces nice little images that we can see. So I'm just going to show this to you now, and then in the corner of the screen, I'll actually show you what the thermal imager actually looks like. But what we're going to do is I'm just going to take my hand, and you can see already it's glowing up fairly nicely because, well, my body is warm, and so I'm going to start to produce infrared light. You know, Yoda was quite correct when he said it in The Empire Strikes Back. Luminous beings are we, not these constructions of crude matter. I'm garbling the quotes on that one, but the point is, you are actually a luminous being. You are genuinely giving off light. Now, the thing about the Mandalorian is that, as I've got my hand on the table here, I am actually heating up the table as well, which means if I take my hand away, and very quickly to do that, the imprint of my heat is still there. That's not ever so good on this table. I think I might just switch to a different one and have a different image on there. But there we go. That's how that works. So, there you are. Now, the cool thing about this is that if you then go around to looking at the floor, then actually, yeah, the imprints of my feet are still there, and I'm going to show that to you now. So what I'm doing now is I'm literally just walking around my classroom, walking, and walking around the tables, and walking. Gee, it's gonna take a long time, but eventually what we'll do is we'll stop and we'll just have a quick look with the thermal camera, and oh dear, we don't really see much at all, because, well, the heat I'm producing from my feet is not actually being transferred straight to the ground. It's also rather cold in here today, which means that the ground is fairly cold, and so it basically soles my feet. But if I was just to kick off my shoes, okay, and then do the same sort of thing again, all right, and turn around, there you go, you can see the imprint of my feet on there. And let's just take a picture of that. See my shoes glowing up nice there with my heat. And then there we go. That's my feet. There we go. All right. Now, there is another question on this one. What are we going to do to actually beat the Mandalorian and want to hide from him? Well, let's show you that to you now. All right. Now, thing is, we want to be able to hide from Mandalorian, and the way the Rebel Shock Trooper does it is by basically doing some gymnastics. Now, I am not a PE teacher, so I can't do that. So what I'm going to do instead is use my brain and some physics. This is showing the beaker on there now, and what I'm going to do is just hover my hand over there, and if I put it inside the beaker, it suddenly disappears. Now, the reason for that is because the beaker is cold. So the beaker is actually quite cold. And as I put my hand in, the heat, the infrared radiation coming off of my hand will go into the beaker and will actually start to warm it up, but it will basically be blocked because until this thing is warm, you'll not be able to see it. So there you go. If you want to be able to escape from the Mandalorian strap on there or from his tracker, just make sure your feet are cold and also stand behind something cold or cover yourself with something cold. Just be careful of that though, because eventually if you leave your hand on there, then the object will start to warm up, and I'll show you what that looks like on the pictures. So there we go. Happy Star Wars Day, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.